put into words what you're feeling right now.
Unbelievable. I put my heart and soul in the training and made some big sacrifices away from my family. I'm busy at work, and somehow I just managed to train hard, stay committed to what I was after, and I achieved my goal.
Let's talk about what you were after. Obviously, this was near and dear to you. We saw you hugging your dad afterwards among the people. What was it, mean to do this for Parkinson's research?
That means everything. I spent a lot of time with my dad. I live in the area, and he's done so much for me. It's the least I could do for him.
What were the conditions out there like for you?
Relatively flat in the middle part. It took us a couple hours to get over. It was a little rough this morning. And then the wind picked up the last 8 to 9 miles just out from shore. So we were fighting that a little bit coming in.
At what point do you think, I've got this?
I felt confident the whole way.
Pretty much the minute you jumped in the water?
Yep.
Did you start, when did you start hearing people and seeing the shoreline, and what was that like?
We could pretty much see the shore the entire way, all the way from the point. It seemed to never move any closer to me, though. It was probably a couple hundred yards out that I could start to hear people.
And what's your thoughts about when you step up, and I mean, there's a couple hundred people here at least.
Pretty amazing. We have a close-knit family, and a lot of co-workers are here, and others supporting Parkinson research.
Anything else I haven't touched on? You think is important?
I know you'd wanted to set the obviously speed record. At what point did you kind of change gears and think, I just want to get this finished and do it well?
I wasn't out for speed record. Okay. I had a goal in mind, mm-hmm. but at the end of the day, to cross the lake is a hell of a feat. Regardless of time.
Would you do it again?